Good morning. Welcome to PNN.
I'm Maverick.
And I'm Jackie.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and remain standing after for a moment of silence.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
It's Friday, and you know what that means.
Here's Peyton and Rian with Teacher of the Week.
All right, we're about to go into the last ever Teacher of the Week. You know what, Peyton, come out here.
Hey, guys.
Hi.
It's the last Teacher of the Week ever, and I know most of you are sad.
Very sad.
But we just want to say thank you to all the teachers and students for all the support. We could have done it without you.
Yes, this segment is so fun, and we wouldn't be able to do it without all your nominations and these great teachers. So
yeah, it's probably over now, so if you didn't like it, it's done. Oh my god.
All right, let's go with the last Teacher of the Week. All right, here's for the finale of Teacher of the Week. Let's go.
Mr. Yates, you won Teacher of the Week!
Hey, I'm Mr. Yates, and I teach game development, AP Computer Science Principles, and Digital Information Technology. I think you guys saved the best for last. I believe I won Teacher of the Week because my students actually enjoy what we do in class. And I'm here all the time. I spend almost 3/4 of my day on this campus. The most interesting thing that I have is I actually did training for Xerox Corporation in Japan. So, three faculty members on this campus I actually were students of. So, Ms. Scarborough, Mr. McLean, and Mr. Long.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's come to my attention that a teacher here at Braden River High School has somehow implicated me in being a teacher of his in the past. I have absolutely no idea who this individual is. Goes by the name Christopher Yates. I really don't know anything about this man. And I really think I need to go to my lawyer and get a cease and desist notice issued as quickly as possible. I fear for my life as this man apparently is unstable.
Mr. Yates, Teacher of the Week? I may or may not have had him as a student. How old am I? How old is he? Teacher of the Week? Congratulations, Mr. Yates. Maybe it was one of us who helped you along the way.
Congratulations, man. You deserve being Teacher of the Week. You know, when I was Teacher of the Week, it was the highlight of the year. And I hope it's the same for you because you deserve it. The amount of time that you put in to this school, and most of the time all you get is a thank you, which those are nice, but you know, the stuff that you do just for those thank yous is just amazing. And you've helped SGA pull off a movie night. During a pandemic, which has never been done before, and we couldn't have done it without you, buddy. I love you, man. Best of luck. See you next year.
I give Mr. Yates a 10 out of 10. He makes the morning great. I come in, I get to just chill, get my work done first period, but also if I don't get work done for other classes, I can just hurry up, get it done first period. Nice way to start the morning.
Honestly, Mr. Yates is just a cool, understanding guy. He's helped me out plenty of times. He's a GOAT teacher, and honestly, this award is really overdue.
But so far this year, I really like him. He's chill. He's overall an outstanding teacher.
3, 2, hey! 3, 2, 1, go.
I don't know why I'm out here. I didn't vote for him, but extra credit is extra credit.
Mr. Yates, we appreciate everything you do for us in the theater department, and even though Samaya is like a pin in your butt, it's okay. It's only because she loves you, and you're like the best song guy we're ever gonna have. Thank you.
I'm not that close.
Back up a little bit.
Good to go?
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Yates, you deserve Teacher of the Week for just being able to put up with Harrison LaVisa. That child is just, he's gone off the rails, and you work with him to put together broadcasts for sporting events, and that's why you deserve Teacher of the Week.
This is like the best teacher. Coding is just so much fun.
This last weekend, the school presented the musical Little Shop of Horrors. It was an incredible production, and here is one of the musical pieces.
Thank you to the entire drama team for your hard work and dedication.
This last week, we had multiple athletes participate in the Fall Signing Day for their commitment to play college athletics.
Here are those students now. For track, Alexis Graham went to Oakland University. For soccer, Kaylee Cooper went to Warner. Melanie Herrera went to UNC Greenville. Emma Parrish went to Polk State. Brooke Tyako went to West Point. And Amelia Vasquez went to UWA.
For baseball, Trenton Hedgepeth for ABAC. And for basketball, Cheyenne Stubbs for Kansas. Congratulations to all the athletes that have committed to play at the next level.
Auditions for the BRHS Color Guard are coming up in May 3rd through the 6th in the BRHS band room. It is open to all Braden River students and incoming freshmen. For more information, visit brhsbands.org.
Don't forget to stay tuned after the news show for the finale of Teacher Olympics.
We will be right back after these commercials. We'll be right back.
I would have to root for the NHS team.
Honestly, don't see us losing. Honestly.
There's really, the competition's weak.
I feel that the environmental team is going to take it this year. This is an awesome turnout, and hopefully we can get the teachers on board for next year.
Well, this is an amazing game of volleyball. I really don't know the rules much. I'm actually new to Florida, but volleyball looks very fun to me.
That's feeling good. We have one win under our belts. Hey, I'm a senior at Braden High School.
And after the loss,
really bad. We just lost, but we're proud of ourselves.
We haven't played sports in a year, and it really shows.
More than a year for me.
I don't even know how I'm feeling, but hi, Mom. We'll probably gotta take this out.
I feel like I just ate lunch. Hot out.
What about that call about the sliding?
I am feeling like that is unfair. Doing good so far.
Come on, Bella, you can get farther than that.
See this? Eating that green cup.
Who cares?
I don't even know who that is.
Yeah, how are you guys feeling as the scorekeepers? Is it a tough job?
It's really tough. It's hard to keep track, and you got to really know the game, and I'm grateful to have this job.
Wow.
See?
Yeah.
Gonna score playing it up for the cameras.
I am Miss Elsden.
Miss Helfrick.
Miss Atkins.
Mr. Blummer.
Mr. Robinson Chanel.
Miss Palacios.
Mr. Hilt.
I am Mr. Hilt.
I'm Mr. Hilt.
I'm Luigi.
Mrs.
Walker,
Ms. Mariner,
Mrs. Monsager,
Mrs. Cronauer.
The snap score is...
Society Walker.
It is. What is Snapchat? What's TikTok?
Little Uzi Vert.
We got quite a show for you today.
Everybody but Nelson and Pink Planksters are tied for first, and taking assets and
Manapolis Stonia
tied for second.
This event is nothing like you've seen before. It is a series of minute to win it games. The team with the most points will be the first ever BRHS Teacher Olympic champion.
The winner will receive the gold, the glory, and the gift baskets. Now to Will and Seth in the gym.
Swing the wind and start!
All right. We're gonna interview our first team, which is everyone but Nelson. As you can see, the name fits itself. But guys, I have one question for you guys. We're competing for the gold medal.
So you're going to have to be quicker than I. I do have a question, though.
How do you feel like a team is going to perform under the 60-second time limit?
Oh, what's the number on the medal there?
It's one.
There we go. That's how we're going to perform.
Alright, let's move on to our next team.
How do you feel you're sizing up to your competitors
today? I think, you know, we brought the color, we brought the spirit. I think we're good.
Let's go.
Our next team is the Pink Planksters.
Guys, I think it's fair to say you are the most spirited.
I think it's fair to say.
But from what it seems, you guys are tied for first right now. So you're up in the lead.
You got some very
competitive teams out here.
Yeah.
So. I think it can go either way. Where do you guys see yourself ending up after this game?
Number one.
We got a cheerleader. He's gonna root us all the way. We got a strong team. I mean,
we got spirit.
Yes, we do.
They got spirit. Yes, they do. Let's move on, guys.
We are here with our fourth and final team, the Kicking Assets.
Are you guys playing with the one challenge?
Yeah.
Not at all.
The least we know, the better we are.
Ice in the veins.
They have the plush jeans. They have ice in their veins.
The Pink Planksters
is gonna win.
Minastonia,
that one.
Honestly,
Pink Planksters.
The Pink Planksters,
duh.
Okay.
Everybody but Nelson.
I would say the Pink Planksters.
Mr. Good Break Dance.
Pink Planksters easily.
Kicking Assets.
Minastonia, no doubt.
Mr. Hill.
Kicking Assets.
Pink Planksters.
Minastonia, for sure.
Minastonia.
Definitely Pink Planksters.
Oh, definitely everyone but Nelson. No question.
Paper Dragon. In this challenge, the contestant will recreate the rhythmic gymnastic Olympic event using party streamers. Swinging their arms in a rapid and continuous windmill motion, the player must completely unwind a pair of streamer rolls. If a streamer is torn in half, the player may pick it up and continue. Failure to complete this task in 60 seconds may result in elimination.
The game begins in 3, 2, 1.
Hanky Panky. A typical box of tissues contains 160 tissues. Dispense its contents one sheet at a time. Removing one guides the next into place, and so on. In the next challenge, using only one hand, the contestant must empty one box of tissues. Failure to complete this task in 60 seconds may result in elimination.
The game begins. 3, 2, 1.
I'm gonna make you mine. I'm gonna make you mine.
know, focus, speed. I am speed. One winner, 42 losers. I eat losers for breakfast.
This is gonna come down to the instant replay, folks.
Lightning's ready.
Baby rattle. A rattle can keep an infant occupied for hours on end. In this challenge, ones made from soda bottles and gumballs will keep a full-grown adult busy for less than a minute, we hope. Using the shake, rattle and roll method, the contestant must transport all the gumballs from one container to the other, all the while trying to prevent a bubblegum bottleneck. Failure to complete this task in 60 seconds may result in elimination.
Game begins in 3, 2, 1.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
Miss Atkins is going for a different technique.
Junk in the trunk. This challenge begins with 8 ping pong balls loaded inside an empty tissue box attached to the waist directly above the gluteus maximus. By jumping, shaking, bending, wiggling and even contorting, the contestant must get all 8 balls to exit the box. No hands allowed. Failure to complete this task in 60 seconds may result in elimination.
Game begins in 3.
Everyone but Nelson! is actually for Nelson. Nelson, who couldn't be here.
What's on the medal?
I'll tell you what. I didn't give him that trophy for the medal earlier, but they've earned the
coach. Woo! Straight to the podium.
But keep singing, because then I can merge it. Hold on, everyone stay still. It will be like the mannequin challenge, remember that? And everyone was just like... Oh my god, this is so awesome. Wow.
Yeah, we should have won.
We have one more announcement.
One more one, ladies and gentlemen. This goes to the most spirited team.
And they are our second place winners, the B-Pig Plankster. You know it, fool. You know how we do.